This is being recorded at the very, very, very last minute. Today was supposed to be a video in regards to New Year's resolutions, but what I had even said is worthless at this point. I had said it had something to do with the person I am now no longer in a relationship with. As of yesterday. Now, normally this doesn't bother me, but this particular person has passed DNR videos have given away. And about me videos. This person had been my best friend for 9 years, and she randomly turned against me because she was afraid. And I'm not afraid to say this either. I was so frustrated with her that in the process of needing somebody who wasn't her and someplace to go, hence the different background, I ended up swearing her out and hating on her. As pretty much my last words towards her. I kind of get the stereotype, I guess. Now, I know some people out there who might see this might go, serves you right, or you deserve it, but these people are like the very specific individuals who have some kind of hatred towards me. I can only think of like 3 or 4 right now. Maybe there's more. I don't know. But I'll admit, I'm human. I have made mistakes based off of my mental and desires. Handle being alone well at all. And for the past month, I have run across some situations where I have been needy. I'll admit that. And it has led to some pretty bad outcomes just based off what I did have planned for my now ex. These particular people, you know who you are if you see this. I'm sorry. I never mean to hurt anyone. But after the events the past 12 hours as of this recording, well, actually after the past 24 hours as of this upload, I'm hurt, and I would say I'm alone if it wasn't for three very specific people. My parents and Denny Wilson, or D9, as many might know him. Danny has been my best friend for over a year now. And I told him about what had happened, and he very kindheartedly reached out and said, said, if I need someone to talk to, go to him, which I am grateful for. There are other people who I could have reached out for, but these particular people are the people I'm referring to when I said there are certain people who do hate me and probably would go, you deserve this. Maybe I do. Maybe the guy, those of you who are under that category are right. Maybe I do. I had something like this coming. But in this particular way, the way it happened broke me. And I should probably point out the reason I'm being more quiet is because I'm at my parents' place and it is 2 a.m. Well, actually, I think it's like 2:30. You get the point, though. It's really early in the morning and I don't want to wake anyone up. But the woman who I am now going to call my ex, still addressing is Silver, because I'm not a disrespectful ass. As much as I really do not like her now. Actually, I've told her I hate her so many times because of what she did to me. That I know I keep looking this way, by the way, because I'm so used to looking at a camera that is in this direction. But I'm not disrespectful of certain aspects, and I know she doesn't want her name revealed. I'll at least respect that, but she knows who she is. And if you see this video, Silver Elias Reaper, it's the full, that's actually her full alias name. I don't know if I'm saying that middle name right, but, because it's not used often, but anyway. You have done me so. She had to be. You know, I'm not gonna address it as if she sees this, because she most likely won't. But she has hurt me to a degree nobody else can. She was my best friend for 9 years. 3 days ago, maybe four, as of this video. Three days ago as of this video's upload and recording, actually, and that doesn't happen often, I found out that she cheated on me with someone she met on an online video game. This person apparently wasn't supposed to get a hold of anyone, but I confronted her about it, and like my last ex before her, she lied and said she didn't do anything. Eventually she admitted it, though, unlike my last ex. Well, before her. Which is a step up, honestly. That didn't hurt as much, because at least she admitted it. What hurt was that yesterday, she did something to me that nobody else can hurt me by doing. She lied to me, went behind my back, and did some things behind my back. She cheated on me 2 days ago, and then yesterday emphasized on that. She lied to me in saying that nothing bad was going to happen between her and I, that she wanted to give me another chance, but at the same time, to this other person, she wasn't talking about bailing on me or anything, but she was talking about leaving me. The reason this hurt was, aside from the 9 year ago thing, she and I made a promise to each other to never do anything to hurt each other again. As far as, like, because remember when I said that I have made mistakes in the past? One of the ones that I did, I tried breaking up with her because there was such distance. And I knew it. However, I tried doing it in a calming, collective, let's discuss this kind of manner. I couldn't do it. By the time I reached back out to her and went, look, I can't do this. I don't know why I did that. I was crying out of regret when this happened. And she claimed to have forgiven me. This is what killed. She never did. She claimed to have forgave, but she never forgave me. She played me like a fiddle. And that's what hurt. That's why, as of yesterday, I had to. I couldn't hold my bearings on my own. Another reason why I'm here. I'm at my parents' place. I'm not gonna talk on about this much longer. I'm a fool for everything that I've done to this point. As far as IRL stuff goes, there are people out there who might come across this video who have gotten serves you right. As I said before, these are probably people who I've wronged. But when I did, it was never intentional. I never have tried to hurt anybody. I emphasize on trying to make people who don't do anything against me, mind you, feel better, feel good, feel happy. Feel loved. But, you know, given the circumstances, they all, knowing these circumstances, they all pretty much turned and went, I fucking hate you, to me. And rightfully so. I had to make this video, otherwise I knew I was gonna go crazy. I had to go see a therapist after what was going on. That's how bad it got. If I didn't, I would have lost my top. I wouldn't be making this video. That's how bad my mind got because of what this ex did to me. So, now I'm single and have a lot of women hating me. There are two reasons why I made this video. One, I'm not gonna try to hide my real self. I can't do that. I'm not going to do that. And two, if I didn't, I probably would have lost myself. Plus, I think I need to make a make a verbal apology to those of you out there who I have wronged. If you come across this video and you feel like you've been wronged by me, I'm sorry. I don't mean to harm anyone, and I'm not expecting any kind of forgiveness from the people I have wronged. But no one should deserve to feel the way I do right now. And I know there are people out there who have. Unlike past videos, I'm not going to show icons or stuff like that. I just needed to get this out. For those of you who are still here, thanks for listening. I'm gonna head off, but I'll catch you guys in another more upbeat video either later today or sometime in the future. Talk to you guys later.